So understanding that people do things different is okay, as long as they're matched up. All right, if you want to find your matchup, head over to georgegankus.golf, sign up for my new membership. Here's the deal. If you're a player that has different motion, and you're not in the mold, you don't have what we'd call a fundamentally perfect golf swing, that's fine. Find your matchup. Everything on this membership is not cookie cutter. Everyone swings it different. You gotta understand what your matchup is and how to make it optimal. Okay, so let's talk about Sam Snead, one of my favorite golf swings. To me, it's not so much a matchup. I think it was pretty much perfection, okay? It's the truth. He had one of my favorite swings. What you'll see from Sam is, one, you'll see him actually more centered here. Okay, there was very little tilt. When you saw Sam Snead from the top, what you'd see is you'd see this trail leg start to extend and you see the lead leg start to move in. His heel would come off the ground. You'd see his spine was actually not straight up and down, not tilted away from the target, straight to even over this way, okay? So he had a lot of tilt in his spine, almost towards the target, okay? So most players who get tilt like he did over towards the target are gonna go a little longer, who throw some thoracic extension. So those of you who don't know, it's thoracic extension, that's just your middle spine. Your top is your cervical, thoracic, and your lumbar spine. The middle one tilts like this. It's almost like a bow and arrow, okay? So when you watch him, he would take it back, his trail leg would extend. This one would come in, he'd start to arch his back, okay? The cool thing about this is now he doesn't need a huge pressure shift. He can actually just start to sit right under himself. And then from here, he can start to just extend back, okay? And when I say extend back, if we turn around and we start to extend the knees, the pelvis, and the spine, that's gonna get you not to have a side bend. This is a side bend. That's not what we're looking for, okay? We're looking for to get around the turn and then extend and use your opposing forces. So when I say opposing forces, that means that you're turning in, that you're pushing in the direction of your hips, okay? You're pushing in the direction of your hips as you push away from your knee, okay? So as you do that, that allows you to rotate through the shot. We can get more into detail, but we're just gonna call those opposing forces, okay? So as you watch Sam Snead would lean his spine over into this position. He'd actually, from here, his knee would be in, this would be pretty straight. He'd actually just sit almost straight down. His nose was right over his belt before he uses opposing forces and then extended back. And it was amazing, okay? Understand now we talk about, hey, that's too stacked this way. Okay, what would be the problem if Sam came over here and then started to really drive over here, or got over here and then started to tilt back like this? But understand, if you can tilt like him, and not push forward anymore, or actually try and fall back this way, but just sit right under you, you have stability. You could jump, you could do things, you can use the ground, okay? So if you're a Sam Snead, you can get over this position and drop. This is a great place to be to just turn and extend, okay? So if you are Sam Snead, or you're a player like Sam Snead, understand being tilted like this is not bad. We've all been taught that this is a better way, but understand if you did Sam Snead's leg work from over here, you'd fall back down here. So what are you gonna do from over here? You're gonna push back to center, and when you push back to center from being over here, you're so stuck inside you can't rotate. No one can rotate their hips from here, okay? But you sure can rotate your hips if you have some spine lean over here back to center and then extend back, okay? And that's what Sam Snead did so well. So when you watch him from this view, you'll see that as he took it back pretty much what we call directly at shaft line. It was pretty darn good. See, a little time steeper, but I saw a bunch of different swings he did. So as he took it back, he would actually get his arm up into a position where he had a little bit of width. It was a little bit more wrist cock because he had this extension over here. As he started down, he got around the turn. The shaft was very shallow. Shallow means this is close to a right angle to my back line. And then as he starts to make the turn and extend back, that thing's right on line, boom, okay? So if you look at Sam, what was his matchup? His matchup to me was extending back over here, falling back to center and turning, and then extending back and rotating. He had plenty of depth. He didn't need to slide to get it back inside. So he had plenty of depth. He didn't need to do this. He was over here in a position. He had more extension with his mid-spine, which got him longer, but sat back to center, shallowed him out, extended back and turned. Done deal. One of my favorite golf swings of all time.
Yeah.